We know that drug issues in Saudi attract the death penalty. That will be the 8th Nigerian to be executed for drugs in Saudi in the last few years. And we have about 24 on death row for drugs in Saudi. And we have about 12 that have been sentenced to various jail terms. Now, the issue with the drugs in Saudi is this. There are cases of syndicates who work with airlines to actually put these drugs in the bags of unsuspecting pilgrims. So we've had cases where truly they didn't commit the offense. So we appeal to Saudi to make the trials fair, open, and ensure that justice is done. Even if you are going to die, you know that you died for an offense you committed. So it's part of that, where you're going to Saudi Arabia, any of these airlines, identify your bag, know that this is yours. So we had many cases of you get to Saudi Arabia and they just knock on your door and say something was found in your bag. Second case of the Nigerians who raided a bureau to change in Dubai, again, that is disgraceful and is an embarrassment to the country, to themselves and their families. And the names of the five of them who allegedly raided a bureau to change, which was captured on CCTV, are Chimwanya Emmanuel Ozo, Benjamin Nwachukwu Aja, Kingsley Ikena Ngoka, Tojuku Leonard Alice, Chile Mika Ndunagu. These five Nigerians who allegedly committed this offense are a disgrace to this country and is an embarrassment. So if UAE decides to be hard on Nigerians, we're going to say they're being hard on us. But we continue to say that one bad apple should not spoil the whole bunch. Nigerians are hardworking, intelligent, you know, Nigerians all over the world. So this few should not spoil the whole bunch, because this has made waves all over the UAE now. So again, these are the five people. We're going to continue to name those who disgrace the country anywhere in the world, and we appeal to Nigerians to continue to be good ambassadors of this country wherever they find themselves.